In this lecture, we will learn about electrical energy and capacitance. This is an important subject when we study electricity and magnetism. As you know, without energy, we can do nothing. So for any electric circuit, we always need to have some source of energy for the circuit to function. Very well. As we learned in mechanics, there is the potential energy due to the position with respect to the Earth's surface. In electricity, we have a similar situation. Charges also will have a potential energy depending on their location inside an electric field. Just like an object with mass m at a height h from the Earth's surface in mechanics will have potential energy mgh, as we learned in physics 1. Here also, a charge Q placed in an electric field will have a potential energy that depends on that location. As the electric field acts on this charge, it exerts a force. The force, as we learned from the last chapter, is equal to QE, charge multiplied by the electric field. And under the influence of this force, the charge will move. There will be a displacement, delta x, for example, as it moves from point A to point B. So the work done can be calculated. The work, as we know it from physics 1, it is force multiplied by displacement. So the work, in this case, force is QE, and the displacement is delta x, x final minus x initial. So this would be the work done by the electric force as the field acts on the charge and makes it move from initial position A to final position B. As the charge moves and as the field does this work, the potential energy is decreased. Very much similar to an object at height h, as it falls down under the influence of a gravitational force, the potential energy decreases. So a change in the potential energy equals the final potential energy minus the initial potential energy, and this is equal to the negative of the work done. Okay? Always the work done here is positive, while the change in the potential energy is a decrease. As the charge gets nearer and nearer to the negative plate, this serves like the surface of Earth in mechanics as the zero potential energy. So the potential energy gets less and less. Because of that, we have this minus sign between the work and the change in the potential energy. From the magnitude point of view, the magnitude of the work is just QED. Now, the electric field is conservative. The electric force is conservative. So, as we learned in mechanics, being a conservative field and a conservative force, the work depends only on the end points. That is to say, we don't care about the path. All what you care about is the initial point and the final point. It could be direct like this, or it could be in any random way. All what matters is the initial point and the final point. Again, just like we have in mechanics, when we calculate the gravitational potential energy, all what we care about is h, the change in h, the change in height. but we don't care about the details of the path. We only care about the initial height and the final height. So it's the same story also here. This is a comparison between what we learned in mechanics concerning the gravitational field and how it acts on some object with M compared to the electric field with a charge Q naught and how it behaves under the influence of the field. In mechanics, we know that the gravitational field G will act on the mass M. It will move downward under the influence of this force. There will be a change in potential energy as it moves from A to B. That depends on the change in height, this distance. So it is mg multiplied by d, basically that would be the change in potential energy, which is equal to the negative of the work being done. The same story here, as the charge moves from A to B, against d, there will be a change in potential energy, which is calculated from the negative of the work qe multiplied by d. As you can see, the two situations are very much similar. For mechanics, we are using the intrinsic property of mass. For the electric field, we are using the intrinsic property of charge. Okay, both fields are conservative. So what matters is the initial position and the final position. We don't care about the way we moved from the initial to the final. It is path independent when you calculate the work or the change in potential energy. Since energy is conserved, then the change in kinetic plus the change in potential equals zero. In other words, any increase in kinetic energy will be paid for by a decrease in the potential energy and vice versa. Okay. So for mechanics, the change in kinetic energy is related to mgd. For electric field, the change in kinetic energy is related to qed. This is the work. Now we are talking about the absolute value here. So QED is equal to the change in kinetic energy, and MGD for the gravitational field is equal to the change in kinetic energy. So as the mass drops down, it accelerates downward, the velocity increases, potential energy is being converted into kinetic energy, right? When the mass reaches the surface of the ground, the energy is all kinetic. Okay? So energy is always conserved. It can change from kinetic to potential or from potential into kinetic, but the net change is zero. When you add the change in potential to the change in kinetic, is zero. In other words, one of them would be the negative of the other, such that when you add these two changes, they add to zero. However, there is one major difference between electric and gravitational potential energies. That is because mass is always positive, while charge can be positive or it can be negative. So the work is equal to the change in the kinetic energy, and in this case, we have a QED that is also force multiplied by displacement. QE is the force and D is the displacement. If an electron is released from rest in a uniform electric field, the electric potential energy of the charge field system. So now you are talking about a charge, which is negative. and you release this charge in a uniform electric field. So as a result, the electrons moves to a region of higher potential. Because it has negative charge, this corresponds to a decrease in the potential energy. If it was a positive charge, this will correspond to an increase in the potential energy. Usually in mechanics, when you lift an object up, you increase its potential energy. That is so because the mass m is always positive. So the same applies if you have a positive charge and you are moving the positive charge up, you are raising its potential energy. Okay? But if it is negative charge and you are moving it up, you are decreasing its potential energy.